Today's video is going to be a guide to Pondicherry or Pondicherry. As the title suggests, I will be talking to you guys about how to go about when you are in Pondicherry, what are the things that you can do, all the places that you can go to, and all of those things. A disclaimer before I get into the video is that this was not a very planned trip. I did not get to explore a lot of Pondicherry, but I did visit all the important places, at least most of the important places that you really need to see when you're in Pondicherry. But I'll definitely be giving you glimpses of how each place looks and how you can go about it and my own experience in the place. Get ready for it and let's dive into the video. First things first, let's talk about why Pondicherry and what is so really remarkable about this place. So Pondicherry is one of the Union Territories of India. Until 1954, it was actually a French colonial city. Pondicherry is officially known as Puducherry. Puducherry in Tamil literally means new town. So there's a lot of French influence here, and it's very evident in the architecture of the city, the way the city has been formed, the avenues there, the food there, the people there, everything. Everything is so closely associated with French culture. Because Puducherry borders the state of Tamil Nadu, it definitely has a lot of influence of the Tamil culture and language. Here is a place which is so beautifully blended of two different distinct cultures, and that's the beauty of Pondicherry. So next, let's talk about how to get to Pondicherry. Like any other place, Pondicherry also has three ways to get there: by air, by rail, and by road. The nearest airport to Pondicherry is not in Pondicherry, but it is in Chennai, which is about 130 kilometers roughly. From Bangalore to Pondicherry, it's about 310 kilometers roughly, which takes about, say, 6 hours or 6 to 7 hours. So I booked my bus from Red Bus. Amount was about 750 rupees. So it was quite comfortable, and I really didn't know how the 7 hours just passed. The best months to go to Pondicherry would be from October to January or February. That is the ideal time to go, because that's when it's winter and you'll have the perfect weather to travel. Next important issue: where to stay in Pondicherry. When you're going to Pondicherry for the first time, it tends to get a little confusing as to where, what is, and where do you actually stay. My personal suggestion: you really need to stay in the White Town, because if you are in White Town, you are in the most happening place in Pondicherry. You know where to stay now. I booked this hotel called the Shane Bagar Hotel. So that was pretty good. It was a pretty decent hotel. The rooms were good enough. We really wanted to chill, but at the same time, we wanted to explore the city as much as we could. Day one in Pondicherry. So as soon as I reached Pondicherry, the biggest problem I faced was the auto walas. So the auto guys kept on pestering. They wanted to take us the bus stand. The auto stand is literally near the bus stand. So as soon as we got down, there were a lot of people flocking, going after tourists, you know, literally asking them to get into their auto and all that. I decided to book an Ola. By the way, Uber is not available. It's only available for if you're going outstation. That's the limited option you have with Uber. But whereas Ola, you have a lot of options. Basically, Ola works full-fledged. It works completely in Pondicherry. So I booked an Ola to my hotel from the bus stand. So just remember that anywhere near the auto stand, they will not let the Olas actually pass through. Ola is the only cab service that's available in Pondicherry. We had to actually walk a little bit more to get an Ola, because the auto guys constantly kept telling that, you know, you're not allowed, Ola is not allowed in this space and all that. So that's just a little input. So that the next time you travel to Pondicherry, it just is a lot more easier for you. So I almost traveled by cab, but you can definitely rent out scooters. Bike rentals are widely available in Pondicherry. There's no need to worry. You can just rent a bike for yourself. I think that's the cheapest means of transport. Otherwise, you have autos and cabs. So usually, I use the rentals or just booked in Ola. So day one in Pondicherry, we decided that we'll first go to the place that's far off. Now we are headed to allll. So I'm using the Ola rentals right now for 4 hours, and I can go about 40 kilometers up and down. According to what I've learned, there's not much to see, but there are
quite a few places, so I think a half day would be quite okay with allll. The parking fees for the car is about 50 rupees. If you have someone old with you or someone who cannot walk or something, then there's always an auto. They will drop you at the entrance of the viewpoint. It'll cost you about, say, 100 rupees or something.
The best part is while coming back, there are buses. There are actually free buses which will drop you back to the point where you started from. Let me tell you that transportation in Pondicherry is quite expensive.
And we had some good time, drank my favorite coconut water. It's very important to hydrate, guys. Very, very, very important. Walking back to the cab, because cabs are not allowed beyond this point. Though, like you just saw, there are a lot of shops in the allll main road. If you want to go shopping, buy some clothes, jewelry, and a lot of things, then you can definitely come to the allll main road. There are a lot of shops out there you can bargain and get for the best prices.
So it is day two in Pondicherry. Today is going to be a little lazy day. It's going to go slow. So I just woke up some time back and here I am. Now I am already late for the breakfast. My sister is here with me. So we're going to go have our breakfast. Mom and dad are already there. So I just cannot miss complimentary breakfast. I'm going now. We haven't planned what we're going to do for the day. Let's see what we will do, what we will decide on doing.
Today I am at the White Town area. This is where you need to take a stroll around. Do not rely on any other means. You just have to go around and watch the place for yourself. Look around, there's so many colorful places here, all French architecture, there's so many homes out there, so you really need to check it out for yourself. I'm standing right in front of the Gandhi statue right there, and there's also a lighthouse just opposite to the Gandhi statue. I am at this place called the Promenade, which is right opposite the rock beach. It is a good place, but it's quite expensive. Honestly speaking, this is one of the cleanest areas I've ever seen. Usually near the beaches, there's so much waste, there's so much garbage. But like you can see, there's always someone cleaning up the place. There are dustbins everywhere. And the street is very clean. That's why I think the beauty lies in cleanliness. The more you keep the city clean, the more gorgeous it looks.
So I did not go to any place, any particular place today. I just strolled around White Town and the beach. So it was not much. There are specific places from where you can get the view. If you could get to those kind of restaurants like the Promenade, for example, or the lake cafe that I just went to, you can get a good view of the beach and you can just sit there. But guys, just one request is please do not litter. There are a hell lot of dustbins there. What matters is how you use it. Please use it to throw all your garbage. You can just keep it in your bag for a while and then find a dustbin and throw it, because it does not take much time, but it takes like a second to just throw it away. So please make sure that you do not do that.
So again, on the third day, we could not explore a lot of things. We just went to one beach, that is the Paradise Beach. And the Paradise Beach was the most beautiful beach that I'd ever been to. It was so good that I really wished that we'd gone there earlier and spent a lot of time there. But unfortunately, we could not.
So the problem with Paradise Beach is really isolated. I'll be talking about that in the next clip that I put.
So we are at the reception. We're just waiting. We asked the hotel that we need a cab because there's no cabs available. So they said, okay, fine, we will get you a cab, but it cost you about 600 bucks. And it's crazy, I know. But things like this can happen. So if you are planning to go to Paradise Beach, one, have your own vehicle. I think that's the best thing. I don't think even in the daytime there are any cabs available around the beach. So just be careful. This is for your safety. If you're coming alone or if you're coming
like with a group of people or whatever it is, there are no cabs available. So I think it's kind of risky because you have nothing to go back to the main city. So yeah, this is windflower. If you happen to be in a situation like me, just come to windflower, they'll give you a cab. It's just a very expensive, it'll cost you like $600. That's all. Just before I had to leave for Bangalore again, I had booked a sleeper. Before I could actually get into the bus, I really wanted to watch the sunrise, which is so important. I went to the promenade beach. I watched the sunrise, although the sun was really harsh, like you can see. But I managed to go there. That was the most beautiful thing. I watched the sunrise. So whenever you want to explore a city, go in the mornings. You will see the most natural form of the city. And I think that's what is most important. You will see it in its purest natural form.
Because a lot of people recommended this place, Baker Street, to me. So I thought, you know, why not? Maybe I should check it out. What really happened there is a completely different story. So we went there. While ordering, we realized that for vegetarians, they have very few options. It was a problem there and we couldn't really enjoy eating there, except the dessert. We tried a few and that was fine. Except that there was nothing that we could really enjoy. And so after having this experience in Baker Street, we went directly to this hotel called the Sarguru Hotel. Well, it was a proper South Indian restaurant, vegetarian South Indian restaurant. I think that's what works for us.
So the important things, I think I could not cover a few churches and the Aurobindo Ashram, of course. I just did not get a lot of time to explore those places, but I would definitely love to. There's lighthouse, there's museums, there's a lot of cafes and a lot of things to explore in Pondicherry. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. So wait for my next video. Till then, bye bye.